the definition that I have for leadership personally is that leadership is ultimately about creating a way for others to do something extraordinary, something that is more than what you're doing. So if you're already in such a space, I think it's important for you to mentor and engage and work with the people that you work with, because at the end of the day, your work will be sustained through what they do, through their lives. That's how you're going to leave a legacy. My name is Carine Umutoniwase. I am a peace builder and youth activist currently serving with Footprints for Change right here in Mathare, Nairobi. And I also like describing myself as the chief cheerleader of young people in Kenya and in Africa, because I believe in their potential, and my role is to equip and call up that potential for service in Africa and starting with Kenya, right here in Mathare. We have a specific calling for underserved communities to work with the young people in underserved communities between the ages of 10 to 25, where we offer mentorship programs to help change their mindsets towards values, more peaceful engagement, more do-no-harm engagement in the community in all that they do. And it actually was sparked by an incident that happened when I was volunteering in one of the primary schools here in Mathare, where two of my kids, class 5 kids at that point, started to fight and quarrel in class. And when I asked them what was wrong, they told me that their parents had told them not to associate with each other because they were from different tribes. So that really broke my heart, knowing what had happened to Rwanda with the issue of tribalism and violence. I did not want the place I call home now to also have the same fate. So we started our work with children, giving them the right values, telling them the truth, and giving them the potential to actually transform their tomorrow. So I've been intentionally working with my staff members and volunteers as much as I can, because I did Fearless Institute a while back, the first cohort, and one of the things that we were told is that God partners with people, that God uses people as part of his plan B in terms of the creation story. We are still creating, and the people that he's going to use is human beings. So. And I know the importance of having faith guide you and lead you in everything that you do. So that's why I felt it was intentional, especially for us as a team, to do devotions together, to fast together, to pray together, to believe in God for the projects that we have in mind together. And yeah, that's why I do it, because I know that change will not come because of Mbogi, but change will come because of that one individual who has decided to transcend the different challenges that they're facing and actually do something selfless in service of others. I mainly do discipleship through trainings, mostly devotions, and doing experiences with my team. Experiences such as Marketplace. We are currently about to start going through the Marketplace book as a team, just to understand how we can bring the power of faith at work. And we also do devotions together every Fridays. We have a prayer day that we fast together as well on Wednesdays. And yeah, so we believe that we learn from each other and with each other. So we give the space to enable us to share our experience in life and also go through development and self-help aspects as a team together. Calling out their passion, just believing in them enough for them to believe in themselves, because we live in a world that is always pushing us down. There's a lot of negativity around here. So being that positive, that crying shoulder, that hug that nobody needed, you didn't know they needed, but you know that ends up actually pushing them an extra mile. I think that's the biggest impact I can say I've seen with Seth.